Yeah, I'll tell you, Mr. Smith. Recently, Navajo Housing Authority was told to return $96 million in Native American Housing Assistance and Self-Determination Act funds by the U.S. Department of Housing and Urban Development for not spending money during its 2012 Indian Housing Plan. Do you believe NHA needs more oversight from council? Why or why not?
Good evening. I think NHA has a management problem. Our whole nation has a management problem. The money that we get from the federal government, its main purpose is to provide services for our people. That has failed. The people no longer look to our government because they have no faith. The people in charge don't even have faith in themselves. We have to change that. The way we change that is send those people home. We cannot wait for an internship. We've got to get, there's a new generation waiting out there. They're educated. They're hungry. Let's put them to work. Let's not keep them down. Let's not say, let's wait till you're ready. We can't wait anymore. The people are hungry. The main purpose for all that money that they spend that belongs to us is to provide those services. They don't care about what goes on in our homes, how much our fuel bill is, our rent. Those kind of things affect the bottom line inside our homes. Nothing this government is doing is helping us. Nothing. We've got to change that, and it's going to be up to us to change it. We're here. We're ready to go to work. We know how to do this. I can balance a budget. I can offer new avenues to go. We need that new leadership. We need our own bank so we can provide our own homes. We need that equity. That first transference of wealth is important. Let's start building our people instead of tearing them down. We got to do it, so vote. Get out there and register to vote. Your vote counts.
With the development of casinos on the Navajo Nation, crimes have increased, arrests have increased, alcohol abuse has increased, family violence has increased, children have come between all of these problems. Are our casinos first contributing to alcohol abuse of our people and loss of money? Second, how would you control the problems that our people are suffering from when it comes to casino development?
I would shut them down. Because it's a bad business to be in. You cannot make a profit off of people who can't afford to be there in the first place. It does no good. Everything that you said does happen. And it just creates more of a problem. If you're going to put alcohol in front of our people and gambling right at the doorstep, then we are going to have a problem. We need to get out of that. It's costing millions and millions of dollars. Those things should be going to education, to a new police force, to help out with the other shortcomings that our government doesn't do. It's a shame. We're going to have to get out of it. We have to look at that exit strategy, because there's no transparency going on in gaming. I think we just have to face the fact that it doesn't work. It doesn't, period. It takes money from people who don't have it. It does create crime and a dependency. It's an addiction, just like alcohol. And there's not enough money to fix it. I would get out of it. I would make it a priority to plan an exit strategy out of it, because we can't do it anymore. It's going to come to an end. This economy can't handle it. It will come to an end. So it's better to get out of it now than later, when it's going to cost us billions to get out of it. Thank you.
Sharita?
Okay, the question I have for you is, what is the one most important advice that you want to share with the youth?
With the youth? Don't give up. Warrior up. Protect your people. There are younger generations out there. I met a few. Young man named Mercury Batsuni. This guy has a lot of heart. Daryl Marks, Jonathan Perry, you probably know him. This is a youth that gets out and gets things done. They bring the issues. They're willing to fight for you. This is what the youth are there for. We have to preserve their thinking. Their way of life is coming. And it's going to blossom, it's going to come out. We talked about the sacred sites. Those sacred sites, that is why I am here today. Because of the healing that I received for my life from those sacred sites. So I bear witness that those things are special. They should never be touched. We should preserve them for the youth. They have to know these places. Because that's where they get their medicine. That's where they become strong. We have to preserve that. For the youth, they are our young next generation. They will take our dreams, our hopes, and make them theirs and go forward. I support the youth from all the way to the young ones. We still have to be young at heart. So the youth never go away. We still have it inside us. Some of us are getting on in our years, but we still feel young. That's why we have to stay young in the mind and in the heart. And that's how we go forward. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Smith. Our next question
is, I'm tired. You can't run from your history. You can't. We need this leadership right here. We're here. We want to go to work for you. The bottom line. When you go home tonight, how far has your paycheck gone? Fuel costs, the cost of food. We need to bring these things down for every Navajo. All that money in Winnemucca is not making a difference in your checkbook. You don't have enough money to pay your bills. Why? Why isn't this government helping you? We should trust. We need to go solar, wind. We need to grow our own food. We need to do a lot of things. This younger generation has new ideas. You can see we're getting together. We're talking to each other. We're not hiding behind our camps. This younger generation is talking to each other. We're going to get together. We're going to surprise you. We're not going to hold out, blowing up balloons, making false promises. We need. But this new generation is going to get together and we're going to make a difference. We need to move on. We trust each other. We can do it. So if you don't vote for me, vote for one of the new generation candidates.
Thank you, Mr. Smith. Our next candidate.